it'll be online and people can see it that way. So, wonderful. Well, thank you all for joining us today to help celebrate Women's History Month, and a special thank you to our panelists for being here and agreeing to participate. So today we are going to hear from four women who work in fields that have traditionally been associated with men. Each panelist will have about 15 to 20 minutes to discuss their journey that they've had in their careers, and we ask that you hold all questions until the end. There are pencils and note cards on the back table if you want to write your questions down. And there's also a survey, water, and some snacks. Restrooms are located in the lobby, and this should take about 2 hours. I hope you all enjoy the event. And for our first speaker today, we have Dee Valentino. Dee is a residential loan officer at Envoy Mortgage with almost 25 years experience. She has a wealth of knowledge in the mortgage industry, and she has helped countless borrowers secure mortgages that best fit their needs. And she has a keen eye for detail that ensures each loan closes smoothly. In her time in the industry, she has seen it all and is always up for a new challenge. She is a strong advocate for her borrowers, and she always puts their best interests first. She is a trusted advisor and a true asset to any team.
Good morning, everybody. Yes, I am Dee Valentino with Envoy Mortgage. I go by the nickname, the honey with the money. That is a tagline, that's a name somebody gave me a long time ago. Back in 1999 when I started, nothing was done electronically. So you brought closing documents to the title company, and as the lender, you brought the check. So as I walked in to a closing, the title company representative said, "Hey, the lender's here with the check." And my client looked at me and said, "Oh, you're the honey with the money." And I have used that ever since. So I got into the industry out of necessity. My husband at the time passed away suddenly. I had a house, I had 3 kids, and now I was down to 1 income, so I needed to look for a second job. In the meantime, I also needed to refinance to take some of the equity out of my house. And I went to somebody that I thought I could trust. And unfortunately, the rate and the program that is thankfully no longer available didn't really benefit me. So he had told me that the rate was going to be this, but when it came time to sign the closing papers, it was 4% higher. And I thought to myself, I was desperate at that time, so I went through with it only to find out there was also a prepayment penalty, which, again, that's no longer allowed. So I had to keep that loan for 3 years because I needed that money. But I thought to myself, I would really like to learn how to do this, to help people who are in my situation and to not take advantage of them. It just happened that a few weeks later, a friend said to me, "Hey, my brother is teaching a class on how to be a loan officer. Would you be interested?" And that's where I started. I went through the class. The owner of the brokerage, who was a woman, said to me, I like your style. You seem to have picked this up. I want to hire you. You need to be a loan officer full time." And I said, "Well, that's great, but it's a commission-only job, and I'm not real sure of my skills. I wasn't confident." And she said, "I'm going to create a position for you in my brokerage. I'm going to give you a salary, and you're going to learn how to be the best loan officer you can be." Within a year, I was managing her brokerage. I had learned every position needed, and I was working with 25 loan officers and 6 office personnel. Out of those 25 loan officers, 22 were women, and all of the office personnel were women. So I had great female leadership from the get-go, which was wonderful. When I left that position, I went to work for a title company, and that was run by a woman. Again, I had great leadership with women. I've been very lucky in that aspect. I did go through some corporate positions in the mortgage industry, and it was male dominated. Even currently, 32% of executive positions in a mortgage brokerage or a mortgage lender are held by women. So that's not a good percentage. It should be a higher percentage. The good thing is, though, for loan officers, which I am, it's up to 46%. So it's almost 50-50, which is great. The company that I'm at now, there are more female loan officers than male loan officers in our local branch. And I feel that for women, no matter really what industry you're in, it's not so much being competitive, it's being collaborative. I have a tremendous amount of support from all of the loan officers locally. We all work at different companies, but we are each other's support system. We bounce ideas off each other. Hey, what program do you have? I have a client that needs this. And in this way, I have been able to build a network of successful women, including myself, to be able to go out and to help individuals that need to buy a house and or refinance. There is nothing better than sitting at a closing table knowing that you've made somebody's dream come true. First-time home buyers are usually the giddiest, and I get as giddy as them. I mean, there's lots of hugs, and it's just wonderful to be able to do that. Sometimes that path is not an easy path. I have buyers that it takes 2-3 years to get them where they need to be, but I'm willing to work with them to get them where they need to be. They just have to be willing to do the work. Credit is very important. It is the backbone of getting pre-approved for a mortgage. So if you're out there listening, take care of your credit. Thank you.
Thank you.